What's good, YouTube? This your boy Mitch TV coming to you straight off the hip. Man, it's been a lot of stuff going on in the NBA. I know you just seen the footage of the issues that the Golden State Warriors are having between the fact that Draymond Green, you know, went off on Kevin Durant when they was facing the Clippers a few nights ago. And because, you know, Kevin Durant asked for the ball when it was 6 seconds of the clock and the game was tied. To me, in my own personal opinion with that, I felt like Draymond Green should have gave Kevin Durant the ball. But the way how Draymond Green overreacted, it looks like he's been frustrated with Kevin Durant due to the fact that Kevin Durant already made it known that he's going to explore his free agency this coming up summer. And there's numerous reports that's on the internet that Kevin Durant is most likely to leave. And there's about three teams that is on Kevin Durant's list. First team is the Los Angeles Lakers. Second team is the New York Knicks. And the third team, it might be like the Clippers or the Boston Celtics. But to me personally, I think it's the Lakers, the Knicks, and here's something that's going to make you say, what are you saying? The OKC Thunder. I won't be surprised if Kevin Durant comes back to the Thunder after winning those three championships. But this issue with the Warriors remind me of the days of the Bulls when 1998 came around and everybody knew it was the last season of the Bulls being together as a dynasty. They won that third championship, and if you look at it, upper management didn't get along with Michael Jordan and Scottie Pippen, traded away Scottie Pippen. Michael Jordan was forced to retire because they got rid of Phil Jackson. Also, they wanted to do a total rebuild around Michael Jordan, but Michael Jordan did not like that. So that was one of the main reasons why the Bulls broke up in 98. If you actually think about it, if the Bulls never traded Scottie Pippen and paid Scottie Pippen his money and would have just added little pieces here and there, still traded some players away, they would have still won another championship in 99. And I think Jordan would have wholeheartedly would have retired in 2002 still. I think he would have still played five more seasons and still retire around the same time he retired back then when he was with the Wizards, if you actually look at it. But, you know, things happen in dynasties. If you look at every dynasty in basketball, except for the Celtics in the 60s, every dynasty have a good run of 5 to 7 years of being in finals contention. Like the Lakers and the Celtics, they actually had like a 10-year run. But then you had the Lakers again in the 2000s. They had like a 5-year run of being finals contenders. And also the Bulls in the 90s. The Bulls in the 90s had a long run of practically maybe 10 years from 1990 8 years to be honest, from 1990 to 98, they had a good run. But it's always like between 5 to 7 years average, but most good dynasties last around that time. But certain dynasties last maybe a little bit over that time. But one thing I've been thinking about is the Warriors has started their dynasty run around 2013 when they had Mark Jackson. But they didn't win a championship at that time. They went into the playoffs, got put out the second round, and then they let go of Mark Jackson, and they brought in Steve Kerr. Then, since then, Steve Kerr had brought them to the finals for the past few years. Like, every year from 2014 all the way into 2018, they have been to the finals. And now we're coming to the end of this dynasty with the Golden State Warriors. Everybody knows Kevin Durant is leaving at the end of the year. So, if you sit back and think about it. The Warriors don't have enough money to keep Draymond Green, Kevin Durant, Klay Thompson, and Steph Curry. They have already signed Steph Curry to a $200 million deal. Klay Thompson deal will be up this summer. They're going to give him an extension. It might not be the max, but it's going to be something close to the max. And Draymond Green, his contract doesn't run out to 2020. So if the Warriors re-sign all of those players, and due to the salary cap rules of the last CBA agreement, the Warriors will be paying 3 times more in luxury tax. So say for instance, their payroll will be maybe $150 million if they sign all max players, plus the last 8 other people that's on the bench. Their payroll will be like $150 to $160, and due to luxury tax rules, it's gonna be triple that. So they'll be paying over $500 million just to keep that team together. So it makes more sense for Kevin Durant to leave the Warriors and go to another big market team where he can play for 1 year, get that max deal the very next year. So it makes sense for you know, that dynasty to die out. Kevin Durant is not taking less money. He took pay cuts to win championships. At the end of this NBA season, he will have won 3 NBA titles in 3 years with the Warriors. And once he leaves, he's going to get his money. Now, here's one thing people have forgotten. The Warriors are still going to be title contenders when Kevin Durant leaves. They're going to pick up a few pieces here and there in the offseason, and they're going to still be a title contender for the next couple years. They might not win the title, but they will be in contention for the next couple years. So, just think about it. Like, comment, and subscribe to my channel. I'm glad to be back doing YouTube videos. I'm trying to get more subscribers. Go on, just like my video, subscribe, share the video, comment on it. Tell me what you think. This your boy, Mitch TV, and I'm out.